The Cyrillic script is the only official script in Serbia today. It has 30 letters and one rule. Write as you speak, read as it is written. This means that one letter stands for one sound. It's important to note here that the sound U is considered a half sound and therefore never written separately. Let's take a look. This is the Cyrillic script called Cyrillica. A, B, V, G, D, J, E, Ž, Z, I, J, K, L, L, M. N, N, O, P, R, S, T, Č, U, F, H, C, Č, Č, Š. Congratulations! You can now read Serbian. Yes, it's that easy. All you have to do is memorize the letters and practice your pronunciation. However, Serbia would not be Serbia if something about it was this simple. You might have noticed that among these, there are sounds you can hold, vowels, and that the rest all end in that U sound. But U is not always pronounced when in a word, in fact it rarely is, like here. This word may seem like an acronym due to its lack of vowels, but it's actually pronounced as a single syllable word. But the trick to reading Serbian is to figure out how many syllables a word has. A quick tip, in most cases vowels carry the syllable. Let's see a popular example. Notice how we can split the name Nikola into three syllables. Now just apply the one letter one sound rule and you get Nikola. Same with Jokic being a two syllable word. Jokic. Aren't you glad you can now pronounce his name correctly? Now, an average Serbian person, me, I'm an average Serbian person, would tell you that there are no rules as to when the U sound is omitted simply because I have no idea and I'm not going to do extensive research on it. This sounds like it brought us to the end of the video, right? You thought. But Serbia will occasionally pull another one on you, like using a second script, Latin. While a lot of languages worldwide use Cyrillic script, Serbian is said to be the only language that uses two different scripts interchangeably, making it horrible for foreigners to learn. The use of Cyrillic script on this land was recorded as far back as the 12th century, some even say the 10th. And long story short, around the same time this guy, Vuk Karadžić, reformed the Cyrillic script in 1814 and made it make sense, this other guy, Ludovit Gaj, did the same in 1835 with the Latin script. Serbia officially started using Vuk's reformed Cyrillic script in 1868, but during Yugoslavia times that changed, as both Cyrillic and Latin scripts were put in use, seeing that they're interchangeable and it's all the same language anyway. Let's have another look. See? They're the same. But you probably noticed that the one letter, one sound rule doesn't apply here. Well, that's where the fun begins. Vuk had used 24 letters from the old Slavic script, added one letter from Latin, came up with five new ones, and figured we could probably do fine without these 19, which I won't even attempt to pronounce. Gaj, on the other hand, adapted the Latin script to a local language based on neighboring country scripts. German, Czech, Polish, and Hungarian. That's why you'll see two letters read as one sound, like J, J, L, and N. So in 1880, this completely new guy, Đuro Daničić, suggests we could drop those digraphs and use J, J, L, and N instead, to which everyone apparently said, meh. But then went ahead and took one of his suggestions anyway, because why not? That one looked good. That's how and why J is to this day used instead of the digraph DJ. To make all this even more interesting, Yugoslavia doesn't exist anymore, and Serbian people today use all and any of these options they like. Really? You can use Cyrillic script when texting and have everyone automatically think you're a weird patriot, or you can be creative in your use of Latin script. Some people just use the default English keyboard when texting, so none of the ch, ch, sh, z even have the squiggly lines on top. Some people use Serbian Latin keyboard but have zero respect for j existing.
Heck, some people don't even differentiate between the two when writing by hand, which results in funny and sad sentiment in educated people.
Even though Cyrillic script is the only official script today, you'll often see official government documents issued in Latin script, because the choice of script is apparently up to every individual's taste. I have heard once, somewhere, that documents written in Serbian language but not in official Serbian script will be considered invalid by the Serbian court, but I wasn't able to confirm that, so it remains a rumor, I guess. I can't let you go yet. Not without this final piece of information. Cyrillic alphabet is called azbuka, while the Latin alphabet is called abeceda. The one I showed you today is azbuka, written in both Cyrillic and Latin letters for script comparison, but here's what abeceda looks like. The same 30 letters, but in a different order. I remember learning both in school, but I don't think I ever correctly memorized the abeceda order. I'm sure you picked up on abeceda being named after A, B, C, D, but the name azbuka derived from the first two letters as well, in this case from the older version of azbuka, the one before Vuk adapted it to fit Serbian language better. That old version had a word for each letter, and it went something like this. Azbuki, meaning I God, according to some, gave the script a prayer-like quality each time it was recited. You may wonder how Serbian people get around with all these choices, and let me tell you, you'd be surprised how many of us don't know basic uppercase and lowercase letters. Walking through Serbia, you'll see signs written in Cyrillic or Latin script, and as mentioned earlier, on very sad occasions, even both scripts mixed within one word. And while some words are easy to figure out at first glance, some may give you a hard time, like restoran or apoteka. But you know what? Just be glad it's not in cursive, because that's a whole other nightmare.